Let me first show you the results of my object detection model. And you will observe that the YOLO V4 model is working fine. That's this YOLO V3 model. And now come to the implementation part, and first I will start from the dataset, and the dataset I have used is this Kaggle dataset. And after downloading this dataset, you are going to have these folders, images and labels, and let me show you in my local repository. And this is the folder, and after this images section, I'm going to have three subfolders and open the train folder. These are the train images. And coming to the label section, and here we are going to have the labels for each of the image and with the image ID. Now combine these two folders and create a new folder called object, and which has both image and its corresponding label. And do the same for the test, and create a folder called test, and with all the test images and corresponding annotation files. And now do rar or zip these files and move these files to object YOLO V3 model. And in YOLO V3 model, please make sure the availability of generate text and generate train object names and object data and YOLO V3 object configured file. And for this file structure, you please refer to my GitHub repository, and you will find a folder YOLO V3 here. YOLO V3 here, and you download these folders. If you are implementing my project, there is no need to change any data here. There is no need to change any data. And if you are using your custom model, then please do the changes what I have mentioned in this part 1 of the Medium blog. You have to change the maximum batches into classes into 2000, and steps is equals to 80% and 90% of the maximum batches, and filter is equals to classes plus 5 into 3 in for my case. And these are going to be the classes equal to 2 and filter is equals to 21. And now upload all these folders through your drive. Okay, and now upload all these folders into the drive. And now we will come to the implementation part. And the first step in the implementation part is connect your Google Drive and then clone the GitHub repository of the darknet. Now to enable the GPU and the OpenCV, we have to run these commands. To check GPU connection, we have to run this CUDA command, and make is user to executable files of run and object detectors. Without make, we are going without. If you are not use this make command, you will not going to be properly execute the below lines. They will show errors. If you run this command, and everything should be clear. Let me run this command. We are changing the content G drive into the name of my drive, and I will show that. Here G drive is there, and we are changing the name of this path to my drive, and I am printing the contents of this my drive. Now let me print the YOLO V3 folder, and now we are copying the data sets of object rare and YOLO test.rare to the current working directory. First let me print the current working directory. This is our current working directory, and we are moving these YOLO files, rare files, to the working directory. It will take a minute, please wait. For me, these are the rare files. So for Anjiprem or Andaram, I have to install this Andaram. If you have these zip files, you can directly run this command using Anjip here. Okay. We are Anjipping this object.rare and text.rare to the data folder in the darknet. If you forgot to, it may take a time. Up to that, I will explain these things. If you have forgot to edit YOLO V3 versions configure files in previous step, you know you can also do that here, and you can also edit object names here. Okay, and object names here and object data here, and we are using my drive and YOLO V3. So this is the path for the backup folder. Okay, and let me close these things and come back to here, and this step is done and all the images are extracted to data folder. And let me show those images. And hope you are going to have the same object folder and test folder, and in object folder you are going to have images and labels of the training data set, and in test folder you are going to have the test images and test labels. And now upload the custom configure file from drive to the local repository. Now upload these dot names to the data folder. Now upload this YOLO V3 generate train and test py files, and now run those train and test py files. And the most important step is you have to load the weights. This step is going to change for YOLO v4, and rest remains the same except the path. Okay, let me run this capture to make a memory error free, and this is the step where our training starts. It takes long time, so please use this hack which I have mentioned in part 2. 1 minute. Use this Google hack, and using that you can save some time, because if you are setting this system in training mode, it will disconnect after a certain time. So please do inspect and go to console. Go to console and 1 minute. Sorry, go to console and paste the error and click enter, so that it will won't disconnect up to some time, so that you can have the training for you can have these weights saved on your drive. Let me show. Because it takes 3 to 4 hours for me, so I am interrupting this execution as of now. Let me show my weights where I have. Okay, and after the completion of the training, and it will store the weights like this. Let me run this, and here we have stored the we are loading the weights which are saved up to 2000 epochs, and let me load it again, and these are the results you are going to get, and here we these are the true positive rate. It approximately these number of images are predicting correctly, and these number of images are unable to predict correctly, and this is the average precision value 68%, and for helmet class, and 82% is the MAP value, and overall MAP value is 75.1253, 75%, we can tell. And these are the true positive, and false negative values. And this is the value of intersection over union. And I will show you the results of YOLO v4. Okay, let me show you in Google Colab only. Please wait a moment. The results of YOLO v4 are far better than before, and the percentage values or average precision values are greater than YOLO v3 model, and all these MAP values are also greater than previous model. And coming back to the YOLO v3, and these are the values as I have mentioned before, and now let me train our own images. Let me predict the images. If you are going to use this command, it will ask you for the path of the image, and you have to enter path one by one here. So what I am doing is, let me interrupt this execution, and now I manually uploaded images to this drive. I will show how to do that. If you are going to use this image, drag this into drive and it will manually doing that. And now do the copy path option here. Okay, copy path and paste the path here, this content place, and now run the execution. It will store the predictions into the it will show the predictions into the file name called predictions.jpg. So you have to run run these things to show that predictions file. These are the predictions of the YOLO V3 model, and I'm drawing with one more image. Okay, these are the predictions for another image. And if you are trying to implement this thing on a video, this is the following code. We have to upload a video. I named the uploaded video is to test.mp4, and if you have any other name, you have to change the name of the file here. Okay, please wait a moment, and it is loading. This uploading, coming to the video, and it be processed as a frames. So all the frames are entered into the model, and the output we are going to get the combination of the frames, same as the input which I have given already. And please wait for a moment. After completion of the uploading, you have to run this command. See here, it is processing the frames and it is predicting the classes percentage accuracy values. And after that, we are going to download this file at our location. And I combined these two files for object detection, YOLO V3 and YOLO V4, and which I have shown this previously. After combining those separate files, this is the output we are going to get at the last. And you will going to observe that the YOLO V4 model is working far better than YOLO V3. And that's all. Thank you. It is asking for the directory, and let me show you these results also once again. These are the results of YOLO V3.